Good evening and welcome back to Let's Play Resident Evil. When we left off last time, we finished up all of the courtyard basement. We found another Spencer family crest. We are prepared to go downstairs in the remaining locked door. I'm really excited about this. So I'm feeling fairly well geared up. Not as well as I'd like to. I want to bring all of my weapons with me, and obviously I can't, which is a bummer. Let's see. How do I want to do this? Yeah, let's go through the graveyard. There we go. Maybe I should have switched out my handgun and got the shotgun. I have 40 shotgun shells, so I should probably use the shotgun a little more. I'm also concerned that I left that broken flamethrower down in the courtyard. Like, I wonder if I'm going to need that again, like if I need to take it and could maybe fix it or something? Or do another exchange, sort of like we did the broken shotgun in the proper shotgun. I guess we'll see. That'll be a bit of obnoxious backtracking if it turns out to be the case, but alright, here we go. There we go. I'm almost tempted to run back to my item room and get some more stuff. No, we're just gonna go down. The two emblems fit neatly into the door. Open it. That it asked me makes me feel like maybe I should go back to the item box and get, like, all of my heavy-duty weapons. I don't feel good about this. Okay. It's an old typewriter. If I had an ink ribbon, I could save my progress. How about an item box? There's an item box. I'm not gonna save right here, because I saved, like, just before I came over here. But I am gonna shuffle some items around. Okay. Well, I still have to use these. It's really tempting to just load up with, like, everything, because alright, first off. Oh, and I need that ammo disc still, too. Can I combine these? Yes. Okay, that's a good start. Yeah, let's swap out the handgun. Still have that self-defense gun with its one bullet I've never used. Alright. What else do I want? I should probably bring the Magnum. We'll run with this for right now. For goodness sake, Jill, get a gun equipped. Ah, back to the caves, eh? Well, this is really secure. Yeah, that's the kind of walkway you feel just great going over. Into the depths. Oh, hey Barry, thanks for abandoning me before, you jerk.
You're alive.
Yeah, I am.
I was worried because I thought you were.
What? Yeah, good job, Jill.
Start talking.
Calm down. I didn't want to do it. Believe me, I can explain.
Well, explain.
Don't lie to me.
Well, Hey, Lisa. Okay. Yeah.
No time to talk. Jill, hand me my gun.
Nope. Sorry, Barry.
I can't do that.
Jill!
Barry!
Well. Oh, now I feel bad. There was a picture of him with his family. It was some kind of blackmail, wasn't it? And he did kind of try to save me sometimes. Oh, yeah. Da, 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 da. Oops. That's interesting. Okay, well, I think I wasted the magnum bullet. Oh my gosh, she's spry. Come on over. Well, how did I get her to knock the one off? I need you to hit this thing. Can I push it? No, right here. This thing. Oh, I can. Okay, I can't get around her this way. It's a little bit of a problem. Okay. Man, I'm a fool. I am really tempted. Really tempted to let her kill me and then give Barry the gun. So this is gonna be her mom. There you go. Give her her face back. You're good. Oh, that's all she really wanted. Poor tortured thing. Alright, I don't have a free slot. But I really want to know. I know, that was totally a waste. It didn't seem to really do anything. Barry's photograph. His family. This is the photograph that fell out of Barry's shirt just before he fell into the pit. There's something written on the back. We love you, Daddy. From your sweet daughters, Moira and Polly. Okay, I'm feeling bad. Let's get a little bit of information before we reload, though. So, I mean, he was a traitor, but it's looking... Oh, and this is the other part of the courtyard. Yeah. The final bit on the map that we hadn't got to. I'm feeling like probably he was blackmailed into doing what he did, so... Well, there's a wolf. And over here is going to be an eagle. Uh-huh. Look at that! I thought this was gonna unlock the locked door. I did not intend... I didn't anticipate that. Okay. We're gonna go down there, but first we're gonna take a look at the other locked door. There's a large iron door, and it won't budge. Okay, well, I don't really have any idea what we can do about that, so let's see what we got down here. Yeah, go for it. So, the sign reads, will not open unless in first class emergency. Alright, so, how do I signify, and oh, we got a ladder. Okay, and this is, yep, just going back there, so. Well, down the ladder it is. Ink ribbons and typewriter. And a box. But again, I'm feeling bad about berries, so I think I want to load in. Okay, but, yeah, let's get a lot of stuff. So, is Barry's gun better than the other one? Can I load these into it? Nope. Well, that's a bummer. I feel like we've done pretty much everything, right? We're gonna need that ammo disc. And that's all the items thus far. Okay. I don't have a healing item on me. I should probably have a healing item. Maybe instead of the incendiary. Alright. Oh, and I need to... No, I have the shotgun equipped. Alright, let's see what we got here. There is fuel, so perhaps I should bring my lighter. Dude, I don't even care about you right now. Come on, take a swing at me. Figure it out. Oh, I do care about these, but I can't get them. Oh, we just got researchers galore here, huh? Ah, crap! I think I want that. And that was a door, but there's also... it's locked anyhow. And there's stairs. I might should go back and just get Barry. I want to hear what he has to say about himself. Lisa might just kill him anyhow, but... Okay, yeah, this is... There's a lot more left than I realized. I thought we were gearing up to, like, finish the thing up. Okay. Now let's... Usually if I make a decision, I want to just kind of stick with it. But this Barry one, I don't know. The picture of his family makes me feel really crappy. Plus, I wasted all the ammo from his gun. So... Alright, let's drop that off. I can even drop that off for now. Should be fine. And let's go ahead and carry this one. Alright, that'll do. Yeah, just go through the graveyard. Yeah, okay. Da 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 da. I do have to give Jill a lot of credit, though. When Barry's all like, oh, I thought you, and he thinks he's going to be slick and like, get his gun at us. And she's onto it. She catches his hand. She was not fooled. So that's an improvement from her seeing zombies and stumbling and falling on her butt. Because seeing his picture of the family, it does make it all make more sense. Obviously, he's being bribed, or blackmailed, not bribed. Blackmailed, something to do with a threat to his family, I'm assuming. And so that's why he's being a traitor to the team. But it also seemed like, you know, the way that he's helping Jill along the way, he doesn't really necessarily want her to die, I think. So that's why he's torn. He doesn't really want to kill Jill, but his family's more important. Okay, we don't need that typewriter. I don't think we even need that item box, really. Through the worst path ever. Like, who does that? Seriously, throws all those, like, boards down and, yeah, that'll do. This is safe to walk across. Come on, guys. Although, maybe this is an area they don't really go to that much. The scientists and researchers, that is. Okay. Alright, Barry, I'm gonna trust you.
Thanks, Jill.
It's not gonna work, though, Barry. Alright, you just gotta give her mom. That's all she's after here, Barry, so. Like, knock her down or something, please. Thank you. There you go. We'll watch this scene just to see how it's different with Barry. You know, I assumed at first that she fell to her death there, or that she intentionally jumped to her death, but maybe she can withstand the fall. Maybe we've not seen the last of her. All right, you. Do some explaining.
I don't believe that thing's really dead.
Yeah, I'm kind of wondering now, too.
Leave this place up to me and go on ahead.
Okay.
Really? Jill, he needs to... He's got a whole lot of talking to do. And he's once again letting you surge forward into danger and I'll secure this place. Thanks, Barry. You're just gonna let him get away with it. Oof. I know me as the player decided to give him another chance, but that's because I saw the picture that fell out of his pocket when he died. Jill doesn't know about that here. And she's just fine with it. Oh, okay, I'll go ahead. Jill, you fool. Alright. Door that won't open. Which one's this? The wolf. Whatever creature it is. Oh, I meant to hit the other button. Because I know this is the eagle. We'll let this scene play. This is pretty cool. I know we just saw it, but I'm impressed by this. Look at, like, you can see the trees reflecting on the water and everything, and then secret passage. You gotta admit, the researchers working here, or Umbrella, whoever set this all up, probably be Umbrella, right? They've got a flair for the dramatic. If you're gonna be a company that practices evil and villainy, You know, you gotta make sure that your headquarters are properly charismatic. And they've accomplished that, so good job, Umbrella. Alright, now then. Down the hatch. And considering we are about to pick up a bunch of ink ribbons, I may well save. Yeah, I know that there's an achievement for beating the game without saving it all. There's no way I'll be able to do that. This is a game I won't be able to 100%. Oh well, it happens. What do we want to save over? I think we can safely get rid of this one. It'll be okay. Lab entrance. So this is what it's all about, huh? Okay. Oh, I need to combine my shotgun shells. And there's one more, I think. Another six pack somewhere around here. Isn't there? Maybe not. No, there's gotta be. Yeah. There we go. Now then. But, I don't wanna... What do we wanna do here? We need to be able to pick up that other disc. I need to figure out where I just put my shotgun. Because I'm not paying attention and I'm being foolish. There you are. Now then. These. We got our shotgun shells, a healing item, and this disc. We'll pick up the other disc. Alright. We'll go with that. Now then. It's playing the very ominous music down here, too. You're gonna die, music. Okay. Yeah, come on over. Here, let's bring you to this side first. Boop, thank you. I do want to pick this up. Do I? Do I? No. It's gotta wait. Because I really need to get that other disc. Aw! There you go. Oh, you punk. Oh, they got me pretty good here. Bummer. Now then. Locked electronically, that's pretty fancy. Parasol. Yes, I will take that. I have a feeling I'm gonna need both of them. Part of the desk is covered in what appears to be some kind of acid. Well, that's really interesting. Okay, watch out, watch out. Well. Now I think it's gonna be beneficial to grab these. Although, I was safely past those guys and to dodge him again, but whatever. Oh. Okay. Come here. Nice wide corner. There we go. I'm just gonna go. Ah, jerk. You as well, jerk. I don't care enough about you guys to kill you. Is that one dead? Oh, he's gonna turn into one of the fast ones. Alright, well, I did that rather poorly. But we're just gonna go with it. For now. If it turns out to have been really important not to bungle that, then we'll go back. So it seems like we've got a whole lot of researchers down here, which makes sense if this is where the main action was going on. So when everything went wrong, this is where it started, eh? Okay, I do want that, so... Oh, doors everywhere. Alright. So I can walk through that door. This door's locked, right? Yeah. And this is gonna be locked. If you can just get those levers on the side to work, it should open. Levers for releasing the door locks. Now if you can just release the locks on the levers. Okay, then that must be accomplished elsewhere, so we'll get to that. Now then. Yeah, let's go down here. What does that say? Clark David. Alright, I gotta drop some stuff. Gail Holland. A memo on the message board catches your attention. There's something scrawled on the notepad. To use the electronic door, place the initials in alphabetical order. Alright, so... we're gonna do this the easy way. Because I did badly going down the hallway anyhow, and I'm carrying way too much gear. I need more free slots. So, we'll just reload, not have so much crap. I'm feeling almost, though, like maybe I should bring the lighter with me. Maybe that was a sign that I really need to focus on clearing all these guys out. Although, again, it's taking up space. Yeah, let's just run with this. I've got another shotgun shell, but we'll worry about that later. This'll do for now. Okay. Alright. Go ahead. Nice! Just line them all up. Can I burn them all at once? Save on fuel? Come over here. Yeah. Go ahead. Now, I blew this one's head off, so could it even? Do I have to burn it? It can't come back as the other type, right? It doesn't have a head. Oh, chill. There. Boy, I'm messing this up. I keep moving when I shouldn't. Up and shut. There. Okay, that one is bleeding. You also. Yeah, come on. Alright, this one I'm going to attempt to do properly. So, we'll wait until it gets close. And then do it. Come on. Climb over your fallen brethren. There we go. Now then. Oh, I gotta burn each of them separate. Alright. Wait, did I just destroy my... No, I didn't. Okay. The herb can take it. No? There we go. You know, I was standing in the wrong spot. I think this the only one with the head is the one I didn't burn. Okay, good thing this is right here, because I think it's when I leave the room and come back in that it triggers them turning into the other ones. Okay. There we go. Well, now at least I don't have to worry about any of these bozos again. Okay, we will leave the herbs for now. But I want this disc. Now then, let's get back to that room and put the initials in order. Let's also explore this little bit that I haven't yet. Alright, so we got a guy here. Over here as well, of course. And we can go through this. Let's do. Oh, magnum rounds. Yes. So nice to see you. Not so much all the blood everywhere. A row of LCD monitors. They must have once been used to display something. You think? An information management server. It appears to be broken. Ooh. VACT. Researcher's note. There's now evidence that when the host loses consciousness, the body goes into a dormant state. During this time, the virus becomes active and rapidly transforms and reconstructs the basic composition of the body. The host eventually mutated into a humanoid creature. We call them... I'm just going to say VX. Its speed and amazing muscular development are particularly noteworthy. After transformation, it becomes more agile and aggressive. Oh, that's great. Already, four of our researchers have died from trying to feed it, turning the place into an instant bloodbath. Ever since this tragic and barbaric accident, we have decided to call its kind Crimson Heads. Oh! That dangerous and precious prototype specimen can't be left there. Huh. We have to figure out a way to deal with it. Termination is definitely not an option. Oh, termination is the option, guys. We finally decided to freeze the specimen and confine the body inside the basement of the backyard cemetery. But I already killed that guy, right? Yeah, we went in the basement of the cemetery, and there was the coffin that was suspended up high. That one wasn't that tough, though. Ooh! Oh, I don't know the login. It's gonna be important, huh? Yep, that's fine. No, I want... How do I get out of this? There. Oh, I don't like this. These are all alive, aren't they? They're all frozen and just waiting to thaw. Eventually, but not quite yet. The cadavers are frozen, wrapped in body bags. A variety of chemicals you've never seen before. No, but there's this. Yeah. I will take the battery pack, thank you. Alright, let's get that first aid kit, and then get out of here, and hope that these don't snap alive. Where'd that first aid kit go? There. Well, it's a good deal that the computer is still working. Else we'd have these to contend with. Kind of worried that they're gonna thaw out and we're gonna have to contend with them anyhow. Alright, what's gonna be the best way through here? Probably not that way. Can we psych them out going this way? It's locked. A symbol resembling a power area is carved into the lock. This is really narrow. This might not be. And that guy's coming behind. This guy's coming up here. Well, let's go. Oops! That's not how I meant to do it, but that'll work. Alright. All I really want, guy, is to head back to my item box and drop some stuff off. Yes, I will take a dagger. Thank you. Okay, nothing else back here. So then. We'll drop some stuff off, and then we'll go back to the room with the x-rays. Now see, the other rooms that we were just in had this kind of like creepy exploring music. And this one has the, like, imminent threat music. It psyched me out. Alright. Put that here for now. This as well. Do I even want to drop off these? I think I might. Could have dropped off that disc, too. Actually, I should look at it and see if any of the log information is just written on it, you know? What do we got? Appears to be a disc for rebooting a system of some sort. I have a feeling we do not want to reboot any systems that they have. But we're gonna have to do it anyhow. Okay, I could pick these up. I'm sure I'll have to go back to the item box again. We'll grab them then. Second on that one in case this was all locked and there wasn't anything else worth grabbing, right? Or anything else to grab. So, and here we go. Initials alphabetical. I did not mean to read that again. Alex Bichette. So A, B. Then C, D for our Clark David. Yep, this one. This must be E, F. Yep, Ed Fisher. And Gail. June 8th, 1998. My dearest Ada, by the time you read this letter, I will no longer be the person you once knew. The results of my test came out today, and as I suspected, it came out positive. I feel like I am teetering on the edge of reason just thinking about my impending doom. I would give anything not to have become one of them. As far as I know, you are not infected. I sincerely hope things do not reach such a desperate pass, but if it has turned out that you are now the last person remaining alive, I want you to get the material from the visual data room. Then, activate the self-destruct system in the power room and escape from here. Please do everything in your power to make this whole accident public. Well, I'm not Ada, but I will certainly do my best. If everything is still running normally, you should be able to release all the locks using the security system. I have set up the terminal in the small security room so that you can log into the system using my name and your name as the password. You will need another password to release the lock of the door in basement level 2 where the visual data room is located. As a safety measure, I have coded that password into an x-ray picture. A Roentgenogram? I know you, and I'm sure you will be able to work it out without any trouble. There's just one more thing, and it is my last request. I hope you never have to lay eyes on me in this state, but if you do happen to run into me in my hideous form, I beg you to put me out of my misery. I hope you understand. Thank you, Ada. Yours truly, John. Alright, so John and Ada will get us into the computer. Great. John, Ada. Okay, so... yeah, Gail Holland. No, aren't they right? We've got A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. There's, Alright, so what did he do? Is there something I'm not seeing here? Is it just A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H? It's not a very good password. Alright, maybe it is. That says we're done with this room. Oh! That's what we gotta do. Part of it is glowing red! Alright, so. We've got... what? Colon... trachea, liver, and lung, or, oh no, those two are the same, right? No, I missed one. Okay, Clark David, stop that. Ed Fisher's liver. There, yeah, and lungs are, Gail is the lungs. No. Let's go look back over here. Place the initials in alphabetical order. I did, but... so what? Is it more like, so what? Colon, esophagus, liver, lungs, cell? We'll try cell. Alright. Excuse me. I don't think he's dead. Da-da-down. Okay. John. Ada. Excellent. Unlock 'em. Hey, hey. Sell it was. Look at all that. Entry into the room is limited to the sole person who deactivates the lock with all of the passcodes. Alright, unlock this as well. Did I get all of them? Was that it? Just these two? Yeah, okay, we're good. Yep, that's all I wanted to do. Some of these doors are still looking locked, but we can go in that one at least, and then up on B2 we can get in that one. So that's a pretty good start. Alright, let's check out this one, and then we'll go back up to the one on B2, and that'll put us by our item room so we can shuffle things around if we need to. Yeah. Alright, come here. Why you gotta be so in the way all the time? Sort of this way, and then... Oh, you punk. Don't be for real dead, okay? There. Wait until I come back with some, fuel and a lighter. To incinerate you. Oh, this is not where I meant. I was gonna check out that other room down below. Oh well, we're already on our way here. Let's just get see what's in here. Ooh. Yet another disc? Good grief. How many discs, guys? A passcode entry terminal. No, I don't know a passcode at this point. Okay, well, let's go ahead and grab this. It's right there. Looking all tempting. What else we got? Oh, a map of the lab. Why, yes, please. Ooh, another door after this one. Locked. Or, what is... No, that was the B1. That's right. We are on B2. There we go. Oh, my. Alright, what do we got over here? Videos are stored on the shelves. They're all security camera recordings. Ooh, security protocols. Level 1. Heliport for executive use only. This restriction does not apply in the event of an emergency. So I can heliport out of here when this is all done? Sounds good. Basement Level 1. Passage to heliport entry is prohibited unless accompanied by a consultant researcher or the chief of security. Unauthorized persons entering the heliport will be shot on site. Yeah, shot by who, though? Nobody's left, right? So, yeah, that's gonna be our escape. Elevator. The elevator stops during emergencies. Oh, that's a problem. Basement Level 2. Visual Data Room. For use by the Special Research Division only. All other access to the Visual Data Room must be cleared with Keith Harving, Room Manager. Basement Level 3. Prison Sanitation Division controls use of the prison. Prison for who? At least one consultant researcher, E. Smith, S. Ross, A. Wesker... Wesker must be present if viral use is authorized. Triple lock door. Entry into the room is limited to the sole person who deactivates the lock with all of the passcodes. Accessing the exclusive output terminals located in each section of the senior researchers deactivates the lock. Power room. In this room, nitro compound is used as the primary fuel source of power. Access is limited to headquarters supervisors. This restriction may not apply to consultant researchers with special authorization. Passcode output terminals. Use and access of the output terminals is limited to authorized senior researchers. Basement Level 4. Regarding the progress of Tyrant after the administration of T-Virus, and it's illegible hereafter. Level 4, you say, eh? The audiovisual materials are filed neatly away. There doesn't seem to be anything important. What about this thing? Oh, shotgun shells. Why, certainly. Okay. A screen for use with the movie projector. What were you guys watching? The film has been set into place. Yeah, let's see it. Umbrella. Bioorganic weapon official report. MA39. Cerberus. Okay, so this is that. Those horrible dogs we've been fighting. Neptune. Okay, the sharks. The hunters. Tyrant. A lobster man? got that claw on the one side. Okay, so that's what's lurking down in B4? Tyrant, and it's the T-Virus, so that's the origin of it all? Bioorganic Weapons Research Group, Development Staff. Is that Wesker, wearing glasses, all the way to the right? Bioorganic Weapons, huh? Oh, that's probably important. 8841-70623. Wow. I forgot it already. Let's look at the files. Do we have it in here? Oh, I'm missing something. Alright. I gotta look at that thing again. Okay. 88-41-70-62-3. Good grief. Oh, no, it's only 4 digits. Well, that's not that at all then. Bummer. Let's see, is Wesker gonna be lurking out here? Attempt to explain himself, or else now that I know the truth, attack me? Not thus far, huh? Man. Wesker! Why you gotta be a bad guy? He's probably the one blackmailing Barry, huh? Alright, well, I'm going to go ahead and wind the episode down here. Please like and subscribe if you've enjoyed this. Come back, and next time we will continue on through the laboratory.